Hi, I'm Dr. Monte Monroe, the Texas State Historian. Welcome to the Southwest Collection, one of the top academic archives in the country. Welcome to the Cornelli Globe Rotunda. Here we have one of the great icons on the Texas Tech campus. This is a historic Cornelli Globe, which, to the best of our knowledge, originally was in the court of Louis XIV of France. It wound up in William Randolph Hearst, the great yellow journalist of the late 19th, early 20th century, in his private collection, and then ultimately devolved out of that to the Moody family, which sold it to Texas Tech, and it became the 1,000,000th accession into the Texas Tech Library. For many years, the Cornelli Globe sat outside of the elevators in the main library complex, and it was exposed to light, and it was almost destroyed. And I'll tell you the story of how it was brought back in just a minute. But take a moment to look at this globe. You will see many unique features, such as the Asian subcontinent is not fully rendered, or is not fully attached. Australia is not fully rendered. If you move to this side of the globe, and like I enjoy telling students all of the time, this gives a snapshot of cartographic knowledge in the mid to late 1600s. And Father Cornelli created this globe based upon knowledge that was available from voyagers at that time and pioneers at that time. That went out and were exploring the oceans and exploring the North and South American continents. One of those people was La Salle. If you remember your U.S. history, you recall that La Salle descended the Mississippi River to its mouth at what is today modern-day New Orleans. Then he returned to France and convinced Louis to drive a French colonial wedge into Spanish-dominated North American continent. And that's exactly what he did. And he led an expedition with ships all the way back and was going to explore part of the North American continent. And what happened? Did he wind up in New Orleans? No, he was shipwrecked off the coast of Texas. And historians, both Texas historians and U.S. historians, have debated for years as to whether he was blown off course by a hurricane or a tropical storm, or whether he just got lost. But if you look at this globe, which is a bit of evidence unto itself, you will notice that the Mississippi River comes out not in the arc of the Gulf of Mexico at Lake Pontchartrain, where New Orleans currently is. It comes out down by Corpus Christi, Texas, very close to Matagorda Bay, very close to Garcitas Creek, where La Salle established Fort St. Louis, the first French foothold on the North American continent, and that's why Texas celebrates Six Flags over Texas, and one of the flags is French, because of La Salle's mission. If you look at this map, you notice that La Salle, who may have informed Father Cornelli, the best evidence we have, may have been going where he thought he was going. Once he got there, he realized he was in the wrong place, and he returned back eastward trying to find the Mississippi River. He got about as far as Nacogdoches, Texas, modern-day Nacogdoches, Texas, where his troops rose up against him. They were starving, they were desperate, and they took his life. But what is important about this globe is that it shows us different things. I tell students all the time, what's missing here? California is not there, only the Baja Peninsula. I've already mentioned the Mississippi. You will also notice in the center of the North American continent, right about where Oklahoma or modern day Kansas is, there is what looks to be a civilization or a modern town of some sort. And it's depicted as a Native American town. There are some references that relate to the DeSoto expedition that came up from Cuba to Florida and were looking for the Fountain of Youth and went up into the eastern part of the northern North American continent and drifted over towards the Mississippi River, where DeSoto was killed and buried within the Mississippi River. But one of the journals that came out of that mission which historian Elliot West talks about, says that his men saw large crafts, water crafts, going down the Mississippi with prominent Native American chieftains riding in those crafts with big headdresses, indicating an advanced civilization that may have been decimated prior to this time by the spread of smallpox disease. Okay, which actually reached into the North American continent, decimating a lot of the Native American population before Europeans actually got into that area. And indeed, we don't know whether that's true or not, but at least this kind of gives some evidence that there might be something to it. And I actually have had Elliot West standing right beside me here when we were talking about this. So it's a wonderful treasure. One of the other things that people should be aware of when they look at the Cornelli Globe are these wonderful cartouches that you see in various parts around the globe. You see little cherubs here floating in the air, and they're holding up little documents and little bits of information. On this side over here, you see these wonderful ships. Again, the cherubs flying through the air and carrying cornucopias and things of that nature. And what this indicates is that Father Cornelli, or whoever the actual cartographer was that drew this particular globe, and this was an experimental globe. It's larger than most of the other Cornelli globes that you see. And I've actually seen some of the maps that accompany this globe as a member, former board member of the Texas Map Society. And we had an Oxford expert come in this room with the Texas Map Society and talk for 2 hours about the significance of the Cornelli Globe here. But you see that they have these ships. They didn't know what was there, so they put all these fanciful drawings and illustrations in those areas where they didn't know what was there. And that is a brief overview of the Cornelli Globe and its importance. And we're very proud to have it here in the Southwest Collection. We're very proud to have it at Texas Tech University. People come from all over the country and indeed the world, and they marvel at the Cornelli Globe. And we hope that all students and the general public will come and visit us and see our wonderful Cornelli Globe Rotunda, where we have exhibits that we change out quite periodically to showcase the wonderful holdings that we have here at the Southwest Collection Special Collections Library at Texas Tech University.